Hello students, we were studying the first chapter of history, how, when and where. So yesterday in the previous video we studied till here. We started from history, how important are dates, then we studied about which dates, then how do we periodize. Now we'll study about what is colonial. To understand colonial, we have to discuss what is colony. Especially, this is the term. Colony means the particular place which is controlled by another country. So in this way, colony, colonial or colonialism. So colonialism is the policy of a country seeking to extend or retain its authority over the other people or territories, generally with the aim of economic dominance means the country that controls another country always wants to take economic benefits, right? In the process of colonization, colonizers may impose their religion, economics and other cultural practices on indigenous people. Let's understand in detail. For example, India was a colony of British people, Britain or British, right? So British controlled India. First they came as traders in 1600. After that, slowly they controlled economic, political and social conditions in India. First they fought Plassey War, after that in 1764 Battle of Buxar, and after that in 1765 according to Allahabad Treaty they got economic as well as political rights in India, economic and political rights in India by getting revenue collection as well as civil rights in India. So in this way the British became the colonizers and India became the colony of British people. So in this way, colonial, it means colonization. This is the process by which a country controls political, economic, social and cultural things in other countries. Simply, in this book, you will read about the way the British came to conquer the country and establish their rule, subjugating local nawabs and rajas. As you know that British came here as traders, but how they became political powers? Because they subjugated local nawabs and rajas. Some of the nawabs were in favor of the British people for their own benefits, some opposed. So those who opposed them, through the battles or wars, British defeated them, right, and controlled their territories. So now in this book you will see how they established control over the economy and society, collected revenue to meet all their expenses, means whatever expenses they had, they got money from here and they spent here, bought the goods they wanted at low prices, produced crops they needed for export. For example, the British people insisted Indians to grow opium, to grow cotton and to grow another types of commercial crops for their own benefits. And you will understand the changes that came about as a consequence. You will also come to know about the changes British rule brought about in values and tastes, customs and practices. For example, they used to play cricket. So cricket became very popular in India. When the subjugation of one country by another leads to these, this is the definition of colonization, kinds of political, economic, social, cultural changes. We refer to the process as colonization. So students, I think you understood what is the process of colonization or what is colonial. Means the control over any country, any territory by another country. Thik? Right? For their economic or social or political benefits. So this is non-colonial colonization. You will, however, find that all classes and groups did not experience these changes in the same way. Means, the history is not equal to all. That's why the book is called Our Past in the plural. For example, the British rule was not negative to all equally, because those people who supported British people got benefit, who opposed, right, they got suffered. So in this way, history is not equal, the past was not equal to all the people. So this was the process of colonization or colonial. So who were colonizers? British people were colonizers. Indians were colonial, means colonies, and this was the process of colonization. Now, how do we know about colonization? What happened within previous 250 years, how did we come to know? Through some kinds of records. So let's understand about administration produces records. How the British administrators or administration created the record through which our historians got the knowledge about that particular period. One important source of is the official records of the British administration. One important source, official records. What kind of records? Official. The British believed that the act of writing was important. Every instruction, plan, policy, decision, agreement, investigation had to be clearly written up. Once this was done, things could be properly studied and debated. They wanted to make it easy to rule over India. So this conviction produced an administrative culture of memos, notings, and reports. What do you understand by memos? Memos is also known as memorandum. Memorandum, right? It is also known as memorandum. Memorandum is one kind of written message. Written message which is internally communicated, right? Internal communication. For internal communication, we can use memorandum in any institution, in any business group, like that. So they wanted to secure them in written form. Okay. So the British also felt that all important documents and letters needed to be carefully preserved. So they set up record rooms to preserve the documents. What did they do? They set up record rooms attached to all administrative institutions. The village tehsildar's office, the collectorates, the commissioner's office, the provincial secretariats, the law courts, all had their record rooms, specialized institutions like archives and museums. As you know that, what do you understand by archives? Archives are the places where written material is kept safe, where documents are kept safe, were also established to preserve important records. So in this way, we have studied that what kind of material is available and how it was preserved by the British people. Letters and memos that moved from one branch of the administration to another in the early years of the 19th century can still be read in the archives. We can read still now in the archives. You can also study the notes and reports that district officials prepared, or the instructions and directives that were sent by officials at the top to provincial administrators. For example, this one, see here, reports to the Home Department. This is the report found in 1946. The colonial government in India was trying to put down a mutiny that broke out on the ships of the Royal Indian Navy. At that time, our navy was called Royal Indian Navy. So here is a sample of the kind of reports the Home Department got from the different dockyards. For example, from Mumbai, we came to know that arrangements have been made for the army to take over ships and establishment. And from Karachi, 301 mutineers are under arrest, and a few more strongly suspected are to be arrested. And from Visakhapatnam, the position is completely under control and no violence has occurred. So this kind of record is found that was prepared by the British administrators. In the early years of the 19th century, these documents were carefully copied and beautifully written by calligraphists. Who are calligraphists? Those people who write in beautiful writing. So by those who specialized in the art of beautiful writing, क्लियर, बाय द मिडिल ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी विद द स्प्रेड ऑफ प्रिंटिंग मल्टीपल कॉपीज ऑफ दीज रिकॉर्ड्स वर प्रिंटेड एज प्रोसीडिंग्स ऑफ ईच गवर्नमेंट डिपार्टमेंट. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट कॉलोनियल एंड दे आर रिकॉर्ड कैप्ट बाई दैम बाई द ब्रिटिश एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर्स. सी फिगर नंबर फोर, दिस इज फिगर ऑफ नेशनल आर्काइव्स ऑफ इंडिया. केम अप इन 1920s इन दिल्ली. व्हेन न्यू दिल्ली वॉज बिल्ड द नेशनल म्यूजियम एंड नेशनल आर्काइव्स वर बोथ लोकेटेड क्लोज टू वायस रेगल पैलेस. दिस लोकेशन रिफ्लेक्ट्स द इम्पोर्टेंस दीज इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैड इन ब्रिटिश इमेजिनेशन. राइट, सो द नेशनल आर्काइव्स ऑफ इंडिया नाउ इट इज लोकेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली, लोकेटेड इन न्यू दिल्ली. राइट, बट इट वॉज एस्टेब्लिश इन द बिगिनिंग इन 1891 इन कैलकटा. सो यू हैव टू रिमेंबर दैट द नेशनल आर्काइव्स ऑफ इंडिया वॉज सेटअप फर्स्ट इन 1891 इन कैलकटा, बट इट वॉज शिफ्टेड टू न्यू दिल्ली, शिफ्टेड टू न्यू दिल्ली इन 1911 अंडर द प्रोक्लेमेशन ऑफ दिल्ली दरबार बाई जॉर्ज फिफ्थ. बाई जॉर्ज फिफ्थ, जॉर्ज फिफ्थ वॉज द किंग ऑफ ब्रिटेन, केम देयर इन द टाइम ऑफ लॉर्ड हार्डिंग. ही वॉज द वॉइसरॉय एट दैट टाइम. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट नेशनल आर्काइव्स ऑफ इंडिया. वन मोर थिंग आई एम टेलिंग यू अबाउट दिस आर्काइव्स. नाउ इट इज नोन एज म्यूजियम ऑफ नेशनल आर्काइव्स, म्यूजियम ऑफ नेशनल आर्काइव्स. राइट, एंड इट वॉज डिक्लेयर्ड ओपन टू ऑल जनरल पीपल फ्रॉम 6 जुलाई 1998 बाई इंडियन प्रेजिडेंट के आर नारायणन. सो नाउ यू कैन ऑल्सो विजिट देयर एंड यू कैन सी द डिफरेंट थिंग्स कैप्ट इन द नेशनल आर्काइव्स ऑफ इंडिया. सो टिल नाउ वी हैव स्टडीड दिस थिंग. इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो वील स्टडी द चैप्टर फादर. सो यू हैव टू रिवाइज वॉच दिस वीडियो अगेन एंड इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट यू कैन आस्क मी इन द मैसेज. राइट, राइटिंग इन कमेंट बॉक्स. थैंक यू.